Yeah, that's the GT here for another YouTube video, and or should I say, in this case, another mini series or series. Going back, way back to some old information, which, you know, and I've seen it before and had viewed it and understood it and all that. I just, perhaps I dismissed it because it was old or, you know, other information has seemingly superseded the older information. And it's not necessarily true. But the thing is that there's an old document, an old research report done back in the 60s that basically has laid out everything, the plan, the UN, the New World Order, the plan. And, you know, if you look at all the different parts of it, you can see them all in progress or implemented already. And you can see the progression of how things have gone along during over time since, you know, the 60s, which is, you know, like I was born. These things were being talked about and implemented and starting, and they were thinking about this, talking about it before I was born. Right. You know. Obviously, I mean, you know, the whole, you know, step-by-step process, of course, and as I've said, is intergenerational, and it is well planned out, and it is more or less Luciferian, because the New World Order is the Luciferian order. You know, it is in preparation for the Antichrist and the beast system and all that. And what I want to impress upon everyone is that this stuff has been laid out, number one. It's implemented, or it's almost fully implemented. And the pieces that haven't been fully implemented are in the works, okay? You know, one must just understand, this stuff is pushing forward. It's going through, it's being rammed down our throats, left and right. But still, you know, people don't seem to understand, don't see. Now, I've said some things about the sheeple and all that, and I believe there's kind of a, you know, there's an awakening, and I've talked about that. If you go back and look at my, you know, just put in the search thing, awakening, or whatever, and you'll see some videos about the awakening, what I think it is, and whatever. And if you've been with me and you've been watching my stuff, then you know how I think and how I feel about it, and what it is, and what I think it is, and what it's all about. If not, then I just can only urge you to take a look, and, you know, don't just look at mine, you know, look at different people's stuff, because there's different aspects and different avenues, and different people talk about different things, and some, you know, some people are good or better about, you know, talking about one particular aspect of it, the symbolism, or, you know, like Nicholson 1968, is it? I don't know. You know, RSE, Grand Saturday, whatever. You know, and that's not to say that I endorse everything that they say or do or whatever, but there are, you know, use your own discernment and gather the information to yourself so that you can discern and you know, collate it, whatever you're going to do with it. But, you know, if you pray about it, and, you know, have some discernment, have some understanding, have some knowledge and whatever to apply and, you know, whatever. But the thing is that you know, I have basically, I've got a backlog. I did a bunch of stuff having to do with Iron Mountain, and I'd like to just throw it all out there at once, and I think I will. So this is a fair warning. I could do more with it, I think, but at this point, see, I'm already getting a backlog. I've gone past this and into other things, so, you know, right now I'm backpedaling as far as getting it out there to you. So without much further ado, I'm just going to put it out there, and I may or may not addend these amend or addend these informations, but I really did too much on this, I know, but I'm going to start out with this one, which is basically just a slideshow and a narrated slideshow at that, and then we'll go from there. And so I want you to understand about the Iron Mountain Report. That's the main key. And that all this stuff has been agreed upon over time and through all of our leaders and through Congress and presidents, multiple presidents. And this stuff, nobody's talking about. The presidents all know about it. They've been signing on to it. They've been bringing these processes forward through time and promoting them. These agendas that are not good for you and not good for me. They are anti-American, they are traitorous, and so one can only imagine that these people are being controlled physically, psychologically, blackmailed, or being tempted and rewarded for doing that which is traitorous to you and me. You and I, whatever. But make no doubt, they are in on it. The government, not just ours, all the governments. Get it? You will see as I am going on, and as time goes, and after this series, I get into more depth and bringing things into perspective. So stay with me and watch this stuff, you know. Download it, whatever. Just check it out, learn something. And I pray that the Father gives you understanding and insight and a desire to take it further or understand more or find avenues or, you know, that I didn't see. And you know, share it and comment, whatever. Alright, well, that being said, much ado, here we go with this Iron Mountain series. Now, the Iron Mountain Report is basically about a three-stage disarmament plan and the implementation of this plan alongside other programs to bring in the New World Order, bring it to power, and maintain the ability for the nations and nation states to maintain. This will be a worldwide system. Those that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, being the Antichrist or the beast system or whatever. And this will be all kindreds and tongues and nations. It's a one world government. It is predicted and prophesied in the context of biblical precedent. Now, part of the Iron Mountain Report is about a threat significant universal, and I'll say global threat that is of a large or equal magnitude to that of the threat of world war. This is replacement theology, or as it were, replacing and substituting alternatives. The alternatives must be credible and they must be accepted by the vast majority of the population. Now, I have spoken in previous videos about these possibilities, and of course the Iron Mountain Report was one of those upon which I based my information and my, trying to get out the message. The thing is, they are going to be inventing these conditions, these threats, and they will be deceptions. It will be an invented series of threats or threat or threats, whatever it might be. Understand that you're being lied to, okay? And one of these that has been partially and for the most part implemented, may have been altered somewhat, is the ecology / environment / climate, pollution, and they're trying to connect global pollution with the threatening the species, the survival of the species, and although originally they were talking about ecology and all that, it's more like global earth oriented and Gaiaism, and it kind of went away from that for a while, and now it's coming back. For example, the gross pollution that was around in especially back in the 70s and stuff like that. And I've talked about, they actually had rivers that were on fire and all kinds of stuff like that. But the point is that the powers that be put out all this pollution, and they are grossly polluting on intentionally, trying to get it to such a terrible manner that it becomes of some great import. And of course this is aided by massive use of the media and books and constantly keeping it in the forefront. And it was like back in the 70s and stuff, that's all you heard about was ecology and pollution and all that. And the thing is that for the most part they were able to clean it up, and I think that kind of went against their whole plan. They didn't want to clean it up, but with public pressure they actually did too good of a job. Here's another one. Now see, this says climate crisis, and this is old, this is ancient. This climate stuff is not new. It's not even remotely new. This stuff is all a part of their scam and their scheme and their agenda for years and years and years. And they use the global climate or the global whatever as the common enemy of mankind and the potential threat to the survival of the species. However, what they're not focusing on is the real problems and the real threat to the species, which is actually sterility and all the chemicals and all those things that they're not letting you know about, and they won't tell you about, and they won't advertise. So it's a mixed message. But the environment is the global threat that they are using as opposed to the threat of nuclear war, because frankly, they're not going to have a global nuclear war At least it's not foreseen, not right now. But what's the scam about? It's about taking over the land, taking it out of the hands of the people, and putting it in the hands of the elite for who the powers that be and their uses and ownership by these rich men, who essentially will become the great land barons, and we will be whoever is left after the purging and the executions will be the serfs, who will of course be beholding to the land barons. All this all of these policies and all of this grand delusion is played out through the help of eco foundations like those listed, NGOs, and these are all the boards of directors of all these organizations, which are political in nature and not conserved. They're not about conserving or environment. They're political organizations. Even the founder of Greenpeace stepped down from his own organization because it had been infiltrated to such a degree with the socialist politicals that he could no longer even take care of have any control over. Anyway, they're buying up land, they're buying up aquifers, they're buying up resources and metals and minerals and all that, under the guise of conservation and to preserve the earth. However, what it's all about is getting the resources and eliminating private property from the everyday person. And so what they can't purchase by normal means, they will use, take away or out of the control of the owners now through zoning, other land grab means, like with the Bundy case. That would be a recent case in point, also under the guise of protecting wildlife or some endangered species like the tortoise with the Bundys, the snowy owl up there with the in the northwest for the timber land and the timber industry, and the goby in the California breadbasket. Part of this land may or could be used as a swap for debt. The banksters are in such debt at this point that I believe that, and even as far back as when this slide / movie was made, film, they were talking about land swaps for debt, and debt wasn't even that bad back then. Now it's like, Obama comes in, it was about $8 billion, now it's $18 billion. They're taking away our land. Okay, when they get done, they will own all the land, all resources, and control all the food and all the water. Then, as now, they are the masters and we the slaves. Only, there's going to be, and I believe, and it's not really within the context of this slide or slideshow or whatever, but, the purge and the destruction. But as you can see, the prophecies of the end times, they will rule over many and shall divide the land for gain. So what they want to do, this one world government, they're gonna divide up all the lands of all the nations among all these power that be, and they'll have their own little, kingdoms or serfdoms or whatever, And part of this this will be achieved with the global warming treaties and through deforestation and biodiversity treaties, which are international, have no binding or validity, but they will just go ahead and enforce them, and they will make them policy through regulations, quasi-legislative bodies like the EPA and the FDA and stuff like that, and so forth and so on. The Iron Mountain Agenda for the environment has been implemented. It has been, for the most part, fairly successful. They've got people brainwashed into believing all of their pseudoscience and their lies of consensus and global warming and all that, even though there hasn't been any global warming whatsoever. They don't pay any attention to science or real data, okay? Another thing that they demonize is CO2, okay? CO2, without CO2, the plants die. Without the plants, we die, okay? So it's not really about CO2. It's just about, you know, making a treaty and then punishing the Western nations. And what it is, it's an economic tie to climate and the environment. So they also throw in there the endangered species and all that, and they try to scare people into thinking like all the wildlife is going extinct and the earth is going to die or fry or whatever. And it's just not true. It's a lie, it's a deception. And it's a series of deceptions, and it's all about climate and environment and development and economic correlates of the West, thereby tightening the control and reducing the capacity of Western nations to compete, and strangling them out even further because they're not needed. You know, they don't need a middle class, they don't need an upper class, they've got that covered. All they need is serfs and land bearing. Okay, another one of these threats, and I've talked about this before in my World War III or scenarios, end time scenarios or schemas or whatever, is the alien agenda, okay? Now this basically, and I don't know, it's been going on for quite some time, and I talked about that in my War of the Worlds video too, about the threat of the creatures from outer space and how that will dovetail into the need for a one world government to deal with the possible invasion or, you know, what have you. Even President Reagan got up, and Clinton, and I've got both of them saying something to the effect that, you know, well, you know, we might, yeah, just think if we had this, you know, threat from outer space and all of a sudden we would be brothers and arms and whatever. And so that's part of the end time delusion, the UFOs and the alien agenda and all that. And by necessity it will require certain prerequisite understandings and adopting certain standpoints like scientism and evolution and such other, and well, of course the environment and the climate change, but two keys are evolution and accepting extraterrestrials as, you know, possible, and I think You know, they've even got the curriculum in the schools talking about SETI. And I remember at least one of my children was involved in a project with that when he was in either middle school or high school. And I remember collecting some SETI data with him up in my lab. But, you know, and you know, of course, all this stuff goes along with the media and movies and a series of movies that have implemented and changed the way that we all think about extraterrestrials and all that. But in general, they're all like, you know, we got to stop war. We have to, you know, evolution is part of it, you know, establishing the truth of evolution and how different species look different and come from different places. And kind of a universal need for, you know, okay, everybody quit, you know, doing war and have peace and you know, get along, the evolution. And you need a one world government or a world federation of some kind, or a federation even of planets, perhaps. And that latter point, of course, was emphasizing Star Wars, as well as the 1969 series Star Trek, which was run over and over and over. You know, and I don't know if it was really that good. But, you know, TV was pretty crappy back then. So, you know, but Close Encounters was another one where they connected the military and the UN and mankind all together. You know, in the end scene, they exchanged people. Some ETs stayed here and some Earthlings went up there and with them and all that, you see. Let's say this is all part of the pre-programming and the media manipulation and the brainwashing that we've been getting over the years. And you know, this is started with President Truman and Operation Majestic, a top secret operation, which I might talk about more in future. But his call in 1947, I believe, is, you know, the incident in New Mexico, and then all the Area 51 stuff, and, you know, the hubbub about aliens landing and all that. Basically, this is the reinitialization of the program started with Orson Welles' play that he did, War of the Worlds. And again, this requires, you know, the belief in evolution and you're replacing creation and belief in Christ and in God and in the creation story that is set forth in the Bible, and replacing it or substituting it with evolution and this system. But this system denies God, and since people will deny God, they deny the truth, then the strong delusion will be enabled in everyone who keeps those untruths held up. And all these things, the programs and everything leads to the establishment of a federal or local internal security force as opposed to military, okay? See, in the original depiction there, you got U.S. and USSR military forces shrunk down, and now peace and security is not through police so much as an internal security force, which means federalization. And then after federalization, then it's globalized into the multi-jurisdictional task force, which is MJTF. And there are stations all over which incorporate the MJTF, the UN, having a function and even a place in place to put people on our soil. And, you know, these policies remove everyone from civil enforcement.
We cannot continue to rely only on our military in order to achieve the national security objectives that we've set. We've got to have a civilian national security force that's just as powerful, just as strong, just as well funded.